The great thing about painting Warhammer is that there's no right or wrong way to do it. However long you spend painting and what techniques you use are, well, completely up to you. As long as you enjoy yourself and are happy with the finished result, that's all that matters.
With that said, we thought it'd be fun to challenge ourselves to painting the same miniature using different painting techniques and paints.
In this video, we'll be each painting a jump pack as a set of Space Marine in the Raven Guard successor chapter, the Raptors. Ollie will aim to get his mini battle ready quickly as possible, whereas Adam will take his sweet time and focus on every detail on the mini. As for myself, I'll be aiming somewhere in the middle.
So the benefit of this is at the end of the video, you'll have three distinct waves of painting the Raptors for three different reasons. Highly adaptable, much like the Raptors themselves, almost like we planned it. Ollie and Emma, are you ready? Here we go.
What gets me really excited about Warhammer is loads of units and big armies. What's better than one Space Marine? 10 Space Marines, obviously. As my goal is to get my mini ready for battle as quickly as possible, I'm challenging myself to paint my Space Marine Raptor in just 1 hour. If I get him done in that time, that means I could paint a whole squad of these guys in a single day. Whilst my speed painted mini may not look as good as Adam's or Emma's, he'll still look mighty impressive standing next to the rest of his battle brothers. I think a decent looking army is just as impressive as a perfectly painted single miniature.
As much as I love Ollie's plan, I do want to give my Raptor a bit more love on those details to make my Space Marine really stand out. So I'm going to aim to give my Marine around 3 hours. In that time, I should be able to get the whole model battle ready, then add some highlights, but not on everything. Just focusing on the armor, leathers, and metals.
I really love putting extra time into every miniature, so my aim is to take this model up a notch. I'm going to really focus on the armor, the coolest thing about Space Marines, in my opinion, and then with the remaining time, I'll do as much detail work on the other elements of the model as I can. Now, I know I can get carried away, so I'm going to aim to do all of this in 6 hours.
Only 6 hours. 6 hours, Adam. Are you sure you have enough time? Anyways, seeing as my goal is to paint as quickly as possible, the plan here is to use the undercoat as the main base color. Then I'll add a quick dry brush and a shade before picking out the last few remaining details. So let's start with that undercoat of Death Guard Green.
I'll be starting with Mechanica Standard Grey as my undercoat to give myself a nice solid but neutral base. As I'm actually painting Raptors and not Death Guard like Ollie, here are my paints. I'll be focusing on getting major details base coated, shaded quickly, and a few highlights to top it all off. Not a bad plan, right? But you'll have to keep watching to see how it goes.
I'll be starting from a grey sear undercoat and then applying my Deathwold Forest base layer from there. The light grey undercoat will help to keep my green armour nice and light and really buy into that olive drab look that the Raptors have. From there, I'll take the armor to completion, going as full out as the time limit allows, before moving on to other elements of the model. Like Emma, I'm using Deathwold Forest as my base coat for the power armor. Multiple thin coats are ideal here for that smooth finish. Because of using Grey Sea as our primer, the final finish should be a little lighter than Emma's as well.
The other two have to get all that green onto the armor. I'm already ahead thanks to my Death Guard Green spray. I'm just going to add a quick top up with some Death Guard Green from the pot, looking to paint over any areas that the spray might have missed.
I'm using a shade of green that isn't so heretical, so Deathwold Forest it is. It's not too drab, but not too pale either, so it's a nice start for our olive green armour. I'll crack on with a few coats of that to get a smooth and solid finish.
Multiple thin coats? I haven't got time for that. It's dry brush time. A quick all-over dry brush of Krieg Khaki will give my Raptor some super bright highlights. Super quick and super easy.
Looking good, Ollie, but I've just finished my base coating, so now I'll start my shading. I'm using Rattling Grind Contrast, using it to recess shade all of the lines and gaps as neatly as I can. If I use a small layer brush, I can get into all of those tricky areas with ease. I could have used Norn Oil, but I wanted something a bit stronger and darker for the recesses. But I can also use it later for shading everything else, saving me precious minutes of painting, as I want to keep painting quickly and as much as I can. I wonder how Adam is getting along with his Raptor.
Dry brush before the shade, Ollie? Love it! And Emma's gone for that rattling grime. I know that's one of her favourite paints. Okay, time to focus because it is the recess shading stage. I need to make my way around the panels applying wildwood as neatly as possible. I've gone for wildwood as it flows really well and has a lot of pigment in it, so it will only need one pass around all the recesses. The thinking for the darker brown is that it will contrast really nicely with my highlights later on and make the raptor pop out even more.
Look at these two carefully recess shading. I'm sure that long process will pay off and look great, but I have another much faster method. An all-over shade of a Thonian camo shade will not only be quicker, but will also tint my dry brush green and blend my highlights into the armor. I'll slap this all over my Raptor with a bit of Lamia medium to minimize any pooling, and then get myself a cup of tea while it dries. And blammo, the green armor on my Raptor is done. Based, shaded, and highlighted thanks to the dry brush I did earlier. Just gotta get all those pouches, weapons, and eyes filled in, and I'll be done. Ah, this is a breeze.
Now I'm highlighting the armor so I can get it finished and move on with my other details, as I haven't got all day. So I'm using Ogryn camo and painting every visible edge, whilst being neat as I can, making sure that my tidy up time is as limited as possible. As I'm only focusing on the armor with one highlight, I want it to be bright enough to stand out, rather than something more subtle. Why do I get the feeling Adam may do the opposite?
For our first edge highlight on the power armor, we'll be using Elysian green. We'll be picking out all the edges with the step, making our way around, being as neat as possible. A good tip to maintain a consistent line is to edge highlight towards yourself. This allows you to have better control of your brush. Also, where possible, use the side of your brush to run along the edges of the model. Elysian green is a great first choice here, as it is a nice step up from the base coat, but not too bright, and thus sets us up nicely for our second edge highlight in the next step.
Black Legion, done. Lead Belcher, done. Time for another shade, this time with Norn Oil on all those new colours. While that dries, I can fill the centre of each eye lens in with White Scar, followed by a quick once-over with Blood Angels Red. Finished.
Geez, Ollie is making a move on his details. I've just got a few last edge highlights and now my armor is finished. It's a big stage, but it's totally worth it, and I'm still good for time. Now I can move on to my next stages.
And with the transfers added and base completed, my Space Marine Raptor is finished. Wow, that was super fun and very easy too. Hopefully I won't be waiting too long for Adam and Emma to finish painting their minis.
Ollie's Raptor is already done. I can tell he's had a blast there. Emma's moving on to the next phase of her Raptor as well. Really cracking on. There's only one solution for this. I'm going to do a second fine edge highlight on the power armor. I know I've been given some freedom here, but I'm only going to pick out the upper three quarters of the armor panels. I'm doing the upper three quarters of the panels, leaving the bottom edges, or what I think the light won't naturally hit, with just the first highlight, because this will help to sell the idea that the light is coming from above him. It's also a sneaky way of getting the model highlighted a bit quicker by saving time not doing all the edges. When doing a second, finer edge highlight, it's important to make sure that we paint within the line of our first layer. This will help to show a gradient between the base coat, the first layer, and then the second layer of the edge highlight.
Right, I need to focus on getting my next base coats done. Iron hand steel for the majority of the metal details will look great here, especially on the chest eagle and weapons. But I'll leave the gun and chainsaw casing as they will look great in Corvus Black, as well as the undersuit and eye lenses, which I'll paint now. Both those colours will take me a bit of time, but I'll still go with the flow. Right, what's next?
Phew, all the armour is completed. Took about as long as I thought it would. I tried to go as quickly as possible here, but my inner consistency demon wouldn't let me rush it too much. Now, I need to base coat all the other details. Lucky enough for me, the Raptors are known for having a rather utilitarian approach to all things. Therefore, I've decided to paint the inner armor joints, weapon casings, and piping with Corvus Black. I'll then do all the leather details with Black Legion as well. I absolutely love Black Legion contrast paint as it covers so well and flows really easily off the brush. This will definitely save me some time.
Time is still ticking by, but I need to get more base coats done. Our leathers will be Mournfang brown, any bullets, relics and fancy details in Retributor armour, and I'll add a quick colour to the lenses and seals with Trollslayer orange. All in all, these details may be really subtle, but they will all come together in the end. and we've still got loads of time.
That's the black details completed. Now, I need to pick out all of the metallic areas. I'm going to have to be rather neat here as I don't want to get any of the metallics on the power armor. It'll be a fun little exercise in brush control while we do it. I'm also falling back on relying on the straight-to-business approach of the Raptors with my metallics. So, I'm going to pick out just about everything that I want to be metallic in Iron Warriors. This is a really dark silver that will look like it's been muted down in order to be less shiny and therefore more stealthy. I feel this is right for Raptors being a Raven Guard successor chapter. So, I'll be picking out the grenades, bolter, chainsaw, nozzles and helmet pipes with Iron Warriors. I'll also pick out the studs on the leather ammo pouches as well. When that's done, all I need to do is paint the bolter casings with Retributor armor. This is a very bright gold, but I'll dull it down with a shade in the next step.
Adam has just finished some of his details, and I've just finished all of my base coats, and I'm rather happy so far with it.
All right, everything has been base coated now, well, except for the eye lenses, but I'll leave those for the final steps. I've got a neat trick to make them look really cool. So, I need to wash all the rest of the details and I'll be using Null Oil for this. Using the same shade for all the elements will work well here as it will unify everything across the model. It'll add some depth to the Corvus Black as well as really mute down the silver and gold details as well. When going around the model, I just need to remember to look out for any pooling because I don't want any unwanted texturing or any shiny stains on flat areas.
Okay, I have 1 hour left. So let's get some Rattling Grime thinned down with Lamium Medium over those details I base coated. When I said it would save me time in paints when I used this for recess shade earlier on, I wasn't joking about how versatile this contrast is. It's a great way to get the whole unit shaded quickly and effectively. As I'm thinning it and applying it lightly, it won't take that long, but now I have to wait for it to dry. This is very frustrating as I can't do anything else.
Okay, the process moves onwards. Time to highlight the black piping details and the leather details. I'm using Dark Reaper for the power armor piping and Skaven Blight Dinge for the leather. When doing the piping, I just need to take a little extra care to try and be neater. It's worth it to take longer to be neat than to risk making mistakes, which will take more time tidying up. Once that's done, I'll move on to doing the leather. However, I'm not going to edge highlight these details in the normal way, but rather stipple highlight across all the edges and flat surfaces. My idea here is that Skaven Blight Dinge is a quite nicely muted grey that, combined with a stippled scratchy finish, will make the leather look worn and used. Again, trying to nicely tie into that utilitarian aspect of the Raptors chapter. Is to keep your scratches small and in proportion with the scale of the model. Too big and it won't look natural on the leather.
Great, now my shading is dry and looking good. But I don't have much time left as that took a chunk of my time to dry. But we can get two highlights done in good time and make those details really pop. I'll start with both of those metallics as there are more of them. So I'll get some Stormhost Silver thinned down and crack on with highlighting. I'm on the home stretch now. That first highlight was a bit fiddly, but it's still looking good. And with only one more paint to go, I want those leathers to stand out with the armour, as the dark orange stands out with the drab green. So I'll use Scrag Brown to highlight all of those pouches and belts quickly. It really won't take long at all. And that's my Raptor done, and just within the time that I set myself. I'm pretty pleased with how it looks too. I think I'll celebrate in the best way a painter can, with a cup of tea. Hey Ollie, do you fancy a game of Blood Bowl?
Of course. Think we'll be waiting for Captain Highlight anyways.
Well, Captain Highlight is getting ready for the endgame now, and I think I've got a play that will bamboozle even the Chaos Gods with its time-saving ability. I need to highlight the metallics and the weapon casings. I find weapon casing highlighting quite tough normally. I don't know why, but it always takes so much more time than I think it will. Therefore, I've decided that I'll be using Runefang Steel for both elements here. On the metallics, I'll be doing a simple fine highlight to pick out the sharp corners. For metals, you want your highlights to be rather fine so it makes the material look hard and shiny. For the weapon casing, I'm going to do a stippled and scratch finish. I understand that this is a bit different, but it saves me time. while also making the weapons look battle damaged, I really want to try a game of Blood Bowl. Just to keep the scratches small and in scale as much as you can when doing this method. A good thing to remember here is to use the tip of your brush with very light pressure when adding the stippling and scratching. Okay, I'm feeling rather adventurous now that I've added some weathering to the leather and the weapon casing. I think a bit of scratch work on the armor will tie the whole model together nicely and make my raptor look like he's stuck in glorious hand-to-hand combat. So, I'm going to use Elysian Green, my first edge highlight color for the power armor, and go around all of the power armor adding little scratches. I'm using the techniques I practiced on the leather and weapon casings, remembering to keep the scratches small and controlling the lines with the tip of my brush. The power armor looks like it's not fresh from the Martian Forge World anymore, which is exactly what I wanted. Now, I need to do the eye lenses. I don't have much time left. In fact, I think I may have even gone over. Whoops, I need to be snappy here. So let's use White Scar to layer over the lenses, and this will set me up for the next step. With that complete, I'm going to use Iron Jaws Yellow Contrast Paint straight from the pot and apply it over the entire area, allowing a bit of it to run over the lower edges of the lenses to look like a subtle yellow glow. Just need to make sure to soak up any pooling here as I don't want to obscure the details. The contrast paint will pull away from the raised areas nicely and give me that glow, but I just want to push it a little further. Therefore, I'm going to use Dawn Yellow to brighten up the center of the lenses. Yeah, I'm rather pleased with that. Menacing yellow lenses that make my raptor look like the stealth hunter that he is. All that's left to do is base him, like Ollie and Emma's, and then add the transfers.
Well, obviously this is amazing. All that damage and chipping really goes a long way. It's always cool spending so much time on a model because you know that after all that time, you'll be proud of something you've achieved.
Adam's looks amazing. Those highlights blend so subtly, and that's some nice chipping detail too.
Oh wow, this is awesome. I especially love yours, Em, because you've spent less than a couple extra hours than I did, which really isn't a lot more time considering how much better it looks.
Emma knocked this raptor out of the park. Fantastic work and level of detail for only 3 hours. I don't think I even finished my power armor at that time.
Wow, for so little time and paint, Ollie's looks really good. I can imagine a whole unit of 10 of them wouldn't take long at all. Nice work.
Yeah, Ollie has absolutely nailed it. Such a great technique for achieving so much in so little time.
And there we are, three identical raptors painted completely different to one another. Three methods of painting and all with their own purpose. One thing we all learned from this video is that overall, painting Warhammer is super fun, regardless of how you go about it. Whether you're speed painting for a tournament, leisurely taking your models up a notch, or dedicating hours painting a single miniature, there's always something to enjoy.
Thank you all for watching our video. We had lots of fun with these models. It really shows how everybody paints differently, even with the same model. And they all look great.
If you want to see more painting guides, you can go check out our videos on the Warhammer YouTube channel. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.